plans for us. When we look at that Jeremiah in chapter 29, verse 11, we see that God said his promise for our life is to have an expected end, a glorious end. That is supposed to be our destiny. Amen. Amen. But for we to fulfill that destiny, we still need destiny helpers.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I don't know too much about chemistry. I didn't like chemistry when I was in college, when I was in high school. It wasn't one of my best subjects at all. But I know that in chemistry, there's something called catalyst. Amen. A catalyst speeds up the rate of reaction. When you put hydrogen and oxygen together, chemist says it brings forth water. But there's also a catalyst that is needed to speed up that rate of reaction.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. That is exactly what destiny helper does to us.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen. They speed us up. They open up the way for us. Amen. And I also gave some examples 2 weeks ago. Naaman and the maid in 2 Kings chapter 5 verse 3. Naaman was going to remain a leper for the rest of his life, if not for the maid. Amen. And somebody also said that a life without an helper remains a leper.
Hmm.
Amen. Elijah and the widow of Zarephath in 1 Kings chapter 17 from verse 12 to 13. That widow was supposed to eat her last meal and die.
Mm.
But God actually positioned Elijah. And Elijah told the lady that, no, that flour in your, just bake him bread. He ate that bread and the widow also lived forever. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is always at least one person that the Lord has ordained for you to connect to. Amen.
Amen.
Meaning, there is no self-made. When a little child is born, that little child will die if that little child does not receive the help of the mother or whoever that the guardian says. Amen.
Amen.
That little child needs somebody to feed him or her. Amen. Because the little child is helpless. That is exactly what we are. I mean, spiritually, we need a divine helper. We need God to connect us to who that will help us. Amen.
Amen.
Missing that divine helper can make your life an unfulfilled life. Amen.
Amen.
When you just miss your destiny helper, you will live an unfulfilled life. Amen.
Amen.
My wife and, a friend of mine, we were just discussing about somebody, he was one of the billionaires in Nigeria. That man, his net worth was about $10 billion before he died about 2 weeks ago. So we were just discussing about him. And I now went to research about this particular man because, for you to have $10 billion and, people don't really know you in Nigeria. There are a lot of other billionaires that are not even, rich as he was. And people know them. And one thing that I discovered about this man, he came to this country from Nigeria in the 60s. He went to college, he did his master's degree. And after the master's degree, he got connected to somebody that said they needed someone to supply cocoa from Nigeria to this country. That is how he started his business. He first made his $1 million back then. While he was doing that, he was also connected to somebody that needed raw diamond. So this man left this country, went to Africa, and he supplied that raw diamond. That is what he was doing. And God actually expanded him through that. He had the biggest diamond refinery or diamond quarry, whatever they call it, in Africa. Just through a destiny helper, through one man.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's look at Mark chapter 2 from verse 1 to 12. Amen. Mark chapter 2 from verse 1 to 12. is the story of the paralyzed man. And it says, when Jesus returned to Capernaum several days later, the news spread quickly that he was back home. Soon, the house where he was staying was so packed with visitors that there was no more room, even outside the door. While he was preaching God's word to them, four men arrived carrying a paralyzed man on a mat. They couldn't bring him to Jesus because of the crowd, so they dug a hole through the roof above his head. Then they lowered the man on his mat right down in front of Jesus. Seeing their faith, Jesus said to the paralyzed man, "My child, your sins are forgiven." But some of the teachers of religious law who were sitting there thought to themselves, "What is he saying? This is blasphemy. Only God can forgive sins." Jesus knew immediately what they were thinking. So he asked them, "Why do you question this in your heart? It is easier to say to the paralyzed man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Stand up, pick up your mat and walk.' So I will prove to you that the Son of Man has the authority on earth to forgive sin." Then Jesus turned to the paralyzed man and said, "Stand up, pick up your mat and go home." And the man jumped up, grabbed his mat and walked out through the stunned onlookers. They were all amazed and praised God, exclaiming, "We have never seen anything like this." Amen.
Amen.
Like I said, nobody is self-made. This paralyzed man, the Bible said he was paralyzed, that he needed four people to carry him. That means, his own level of paralysis has become a vegetable. Mm. Amen. There are some people that when they have stroke, they want to be paralyzed on one side of the body. But this man, he was so paralyzed, he was so sick that he needed people to actually carry him. Amen.
Amen.
And we are going to be looking at these four people. The role they played in his life. Number one, they were not weary until they fulfilled their mission. Amen. Carrying somebody is not an easy task. The Bible said they carried him. It wasn't, they did not use ambulance. They did not use anything. They did not use any equipment. They used their hands. They exerted their own physical energy to carry him. Amen. They did not see it as burden, but see it as a responsibility. Amen.
Amen.
When God connects you with your helper, whatever your case is, your helper will not see it as a burden, but he will rather see it as a responsibility, a task that must be done.
Amen.
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 These people, they made sure that they brought the man to where he should be. They did not take him to any hospital. They did not take him to any witch doctor, but they brought him before Christ.
Amen.
Amen. They made sure that they brought the man to where he's supposed to be. They see it that the man becomes what he should be. Not only that, they brought him to Christ. As a matter of fact, Christ was in a room like this. The place was all filled up. When they got to the door, normally they should have just turned back at, "Oh, we couldn't get inside. The whole place was filled." But these people, they actually went and dug the roof and they lowered the man through the roof. Amen.
Amen.
And the result of their help, the man they helped got to where he should be. The man was laid down at the presence of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
That talks about divine location. Hmm. Amen. Your helper will point you to your divine location.
Amen.
It has been said that God is everywhere, but your divine helper is only at one location.
Amen.
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 Amen. God is everywhere, but your helper is only at divine location.
Amen.
Something could have happened at that particular moment. Jesus, could have finished his crusade and moved on. It was not recorded in the Bible that was Jesus' church. It was not recorded that every Sunday or every Wednesday he's always there. No, he was there at a particular time. And these people, they did not miss that timing.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You will not miss your timing in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Jesus.
Amen.
Number two, the man was ahead of other people. Amen. When God connects you with your divine helper, you'll be ahead of other people.
Amen.
Remember the church, that little place where Jesus was, the place was filled. They couldn't get inside. But by the reason of his divine helper, this man that couldn't get inside was right in front of Jesus Christ, ahead of others. Mm. Amen.
Amen.
He got where he should get to. He got also the solution to his problem. Mm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not only that he got the solution to his problem, he also got extra.
Amen.
Jesus Christ knew that if he only heals this man and did not forgive him his sins, it's possible for him to go back to that same position. But after healing him, Jesus also forgave him his sin.
Amen.
That way he could be made whole. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Meaning, when God connects you, you will experience more that you bargained for.
Amen.
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 And lastly, his enemies were put to shame.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
His enemies were put to shame.
Amen.
The fact is that when they were coming, when they got to the door, they saw people carrying a paralytic man. Ordinarily, they would have made way for him, to come in, but they didn't. Those were the enemies of his destiny.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. But when Jesus healed them, that same people, they were so amazed. They were put to shame.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Your enemies will be put to shame in the name of Jesus.
Jesus' name.
We are going to pray some prayers. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Every wind of disappointment.
Every wind of disappointment.
Blowing against me.
Blowing against me.
And my helpers.
And my helpers.
Be reversed in the name of Jesus.
Be reversed in the name of
Jesus. Every wind of disappointment.
Every wind of disappointment.
Blowing against me and my helpers.
Blowing me against my helpers.
Be reversed in the name of Jesus.
Be reversed. Be reversed. Be reversed. Be reversed. Be reversed.
Every wind of disappointment. Hold on. Blowing against me and my helpers. Be reversed in the mighty name of Jesus. Be reversed in Jesus' name. Every wind of disappointment, O Lord. Blowing against me and my helpers. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I said, be reversed. Be reversed. In the name of Jesus, be reversed. Every wind of disappointment. Blowing against me and my helpers. Be reversed in the name of Jesus. Be reversed in Jesus' name.
Every form of manipulation
between me and my divine helpers.
Between me and my divine helpers.
Be cancelled in Jesus' name.
Be cancelled in Jesus'
name. Cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Be cancelled in Jesus' name.
Every form of manipulation
manipulation.
Be cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Be cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Every form of manipulation
between me and my divine helper.
Be cancelled in the name of Jesus. Be cancelled.
Every form of manipulation between me and my divine helper.
Be cancelled. Be cancelled.
Be cancelled. Be cancelled.
Be cancelled.
In the name of Jesus.
Be cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Be cancelled in the name of Jesus.
Be cancelled.
Riba da ba 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 da